Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. In this video, we will make the new Blink IoT platform to make a home automation project using the NodeMCU. And as you can see, you just need a NodeMCU and a relay module to make this project, so you don't need any custom design PCB. And during the video, I will share the complete circuit diagram, the code for this project, and I will also explain how to configure the new Blink IoT platform for any home automation project. But before that, let me show you how this home automation project works. Here you can see the blue LED is glowing, which indicates the NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi. So I can control these appliances with the Blink app. So let me control the appliances with the Blink app. And you can see I can easily control it with the Blink app. Now let me control it from the manual switch. And you can see the real-time status in the Blink app. I have used all the free tools for this project, so you can easily make this project for your home after watching the complete video. So let's get started. For this home automation project, you need a NodeMCU, a 4-channel relay module, and to control the appliance manually, you can use the existing switchboard or push button. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, you can see I have given the 5-volt supply to NodeMCU and the relay module. And these switches are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. And if you use push button instead of switches, then you have to connect the push button across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for this project, but as I said, you can also make this project without using any custom design PCB. Still, if you want to get this custom design PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with three simple steps. First, upload the GABA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color. Then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the components on the PCB. Now let me connect the NodeMCU with the PCB. Before uploading the code to NodeMCU, we have to set up the Blink IoT Cloud. So you have to visit this page. Then we have to create an account. So I will click here. Now give a mail ID. Then I will click on sign up. Now we have to verify the email ID. So I'll go to the Gmail and click here. And here I have to click to verify the email ID. Now we have to create a password. Then I'll click on next and enter the first name. Then click on done. Now our Blink account is created. Now we will click here to go to templates. Now here we have to first create a template. So I will tap new template. Now here you have to enter the name for the template. You can give any name. And here I am using the ESP8266 NodeMCU board. So I will select the ESP8266 and connection type should be Wi-Fi. Now I am clicking on this done button. Our template is created. Now I have to click on data stream. And here we have to add the data stream to control the relays. So I will click on new data stream and select the virtual pin. So here I have to give the name. You can give any name. And to control the relay 1, I will use V1 virtual pin. And this should be integer. Then click on create. In similar way, I have to add next 3 virtual pin to control next 3 relays. So here you can see I have added 4 data stream, switch 1, switch 2, switch 3, switch 4. And for these data streams, I have used virtual pin V1 to V4. After this, I have to click on this web dashboard. Now here we will add 4 switches to control 4 relays. So you just have to drag and drop the switch wizard. Now if you hover over the switch widget, you will find this three button. You have to click on the middle button to go to settings. Now here I will give the name for the switch and I will select the data stream as V1, as I will control relay 1 with this switch, and I will turn on this radio button to show on off label. Now I will click on save. Now I will click on the next switch widget and go to settings, and I will use this to control the relay 2. So I am giving the name switch 2, and here I will select virtual pin 2 as a data stream, and I will turn on this radio button, and again I will click on save. In this way you have to set up all the 4 switches to control 4 relays. So thus we have configured the web dashboard. Now if I click on mobile dashboard, then here you can see you have to download and install the new Blink app. Now I have to click on save to save all this setup. Now we will set up the new Blink IoT app. So first you have to download the new Blink app. For that you have to search for Blink 360, and this is the new app, Blink IoT. And here you have to download this app. Then I will click on login, as we have already created the account. Now enter the email ID and password to login the Blink account. Now tap on login. First I have to click on developer mode, and this template we have already created, so I will tap on this template, NodeMCU Blink. Now here we can add widget to the mobile application, so I will tap on this three dash icon, and here I will add 4 button widget, as we will control 4 relays. Now I will tap on the first button. You can give any name to this button, and mode will be switch. And I have to select the data stream as V1, and now I can exit from this button. Now again I will tap on the next button, and here I will select the data stream as V2, as I will control relay 2 with this button, and mode will be switch. Now I can exit from this button. So in a similar way we have to set up all the 4 buttons to control the 4 relays. After configuring the Blink Cloud dashboard and the mobile application, now we can program the NodeMCU for this project. So these are the code for this project. This is the code if you use push button, and you can use this code if you use switch. Let me open the code for the push button. And here you can see you have to keep all these files at the same folder. Let me open the Arduino sketch. You can download this code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description. Then you can download the code from this button. Now before uploading the code, you have to install the ESP8266 board, and you need these two libraries. Now to install these libraries, you have to go to sketch, include library, then select manage libraries, and here you have to search for Blink. You can see I have already installed these libraries. I have installed this version 1.00 beta 3, and after that you have to install the ACE button library, and again I have already installed it, and you can see the version which I have installed, 1.83. So you have to install these two libraries. After that we have to update the Blink template ID and Blink device name. For that again we have to go to the Blink account, and under the template if you click on info, then you will get this Blink template ID and device name. Click here to copy the code, and now if I go to the Arduino ID, I have to paste it here. So here you can see this is the template ID and this is the device name which you have created. So now we can upload this code after doing these changes. So I will go to tools, select the board as NodeMCU 1.0 and the proper port, then hit the upload button. After programming the NodeMCU, I have to enter the Wi-Fi credential. So in the Blink app, I have to tap on add new device, and here I will tap on ready. Now here you can see this is our device, Blink NodeMCU Blink. So I have to tap on this, and it will connect the NodeMCU with the Blink application. Now I have to enter the Wi-Fi credential. So currently you don't have to hard code the Wi-Fi credential in the code. After that I have to tap on continue. It may take some time. Now here you can see our NodeMCU is connected with the Blink Cloud. You can also change the device name or rename it. Let me give NodeMCU Blink. Now I will tap on continue. Again I have to tap on continue and then tap on done. Now I have to tap here. Again tap on finish and exit. So our Blink app is ready. Now I should control the relays from our Blink application. As you can see, I can easily control it. As you can see, I have connected these four lamps with the relay module as per the circuit, and the blue LED turns on, which indicate NodeMCU is connected with the Wi-Fi. So I can control the appliances from the Blink app. So I can easily control it from the Blink app. Now let me control it from this push button, and you can see the real-time feedback in the Blink app. And there is one limitation with this home automation project, that you cannot control the appliances without Wi-Fi. In my upcoming video, I will try to add that feature so that you can also control the appliances without internet. So if you like this video, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe for more such home automation project. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.